Thank you. Sitting down and writing it one day. And it was perfect too, because it was the very end of this notebook. And so there was something that I was like, I tried to, I think, give myself that sense of closure. So I guess context too is that like the first day, like anything somewhat romantic happened between us, there was a thunderstorm going on, and it was just like we were just sitting there like just watching it, like I know, it was very, yeah, like we were just sitting there on his porch or like or inside and just like watching the thunderstorm come in. And yeah, and so that was, yeah, so like, so yeah, giving that context. You were a summer thunderstorm in my drought of golden sunshine days. Your rain and light show made me dance in ways I never had before, and oh how glorious it was. But it wasn't until you left and I looked at the fires burning up my wildflowers that I understood that you were not the right storm for me, although, and then I was like, oh, but maybe instead, so I put a half of a parenthesis here expecting me to like finish it off and be like, oh, I could replace this instead of this, because this is like how my brain edits as I'm writing. But I never closed this parenthesis and kind of went from here. So this is why I'm explaining why it doesn't make sense. Your rain did not quench my thirst, but oh how I danced, swaying and leaping in new ways I never thought possible. Drenched, and with my eyes and arms turned towards the sky, I begged for more of the light show and beat and bone-shaking beat that were distracting me from the fire scorching my already parched wildflowers. It wasn't until you left, with me chasing after you, that I finally looked around and felt the depth of your destruction. And there I sat, soaked to the bone, in a smoldering field of wildflowers, trying to water the earth and bring them back to life with my tears that were locked somewhere deep within me. As my wildflowers started to wilt, I looked around again and I realized that I was utterly alone. So I took my flowers in my arms, but as I touched them, they crumpled and turned brown, disappearing the more I tried to hold on to them. In desperation, I finally plucked them, roots and all, from the earth. I could no longer hold them. And I just ended up then sitting down and writing it one day. And it was perfect too, because it was the very end of this notebook. And so there was something that I was like, I tried to, I think, give myself that sense of closure.
Thank you. up his passion. Someone you can't live without.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Sitting down and writing it one day. And it was perfect too, because it was the very end of this notebook. And so there was something that I was like, I tried to, I think, give myself that sense of closure. So, I guess, context too, is that like the first day, like anything somewhat romantic happened between us, there was a thunderstorm going on, and it was just like we were just sitting there like just watching it, like I know, it was very, yeah, like we were just sitting there on his porch or like or inside and just like watching the thunderstorm come in. And yeah, and so that was, yeah, so like, so yeah, giving that context. You were a summer thunderstorm in my drought of golden sunshine days. Your rain and light show made me dance in ways I never had before, and oh how glorious it was. But it wasn't until you left and I looked at the fires burning up my wildflowers that I understood that you were not the right storm for me, although, and then I was like, oh, but maybe instead, so I put a half of a parenthesis here expecting me to like finish it off and be like, oh, I could replace this instead of this, because this is like how my brain edits as I'm writing. But I never closed this parenthesis and kind of went from here. So this is why I'm explaining why it doesn't make sense. Your rain did not quench my thirst, but oh how I danced, swaying and leaping in new ways I never thought possible. Drenched, and with my eyes and arms turned towards the sky, I begged for more of the light show and beat and bone-shaking beat that were distracting me from the fire scorching my already parched wildflowers. It wasn't until you left, with me chasing after you, that I finally looked around and felt the depth of your destruction. And there I sat, soaked to the bone, in a smoldering field of wildflowers, trying to water the earth and bring them back to life with my tears that were locked somewhere deep within me. As my wildflowers started to wilt, I looked around again and I realized that I was utterly alone. So I took my flowers in my arms, but as I touched them, they crumpled and turned brown, disappearing the more I tried to hold on to them. In desperation, I finally plucked them, roots and all, from the earth. I could no longer hold them. And I just ended up sitting down and writing it one day. And it was perfect too, because it was the very end of this notebook. And so there was something that I was like, I tried to, I think, give myself that sense of closure.
nothing. But love is passion. Someone you can't live without.
Thank you. Thank you.